So earlier in the week we have Keith and Mary Satan, and tonight we've got Kelly, who is our student at Mount St. Vincent, and Kelly is going to be showing us how to make tofu fried rice. So right now Kelly is just prepping. I'm going to switch my camera over to Kelly so that I can see you, and we can just get started. Hi everyone. So I'm just prepping all the ingredients, and right now I'm slicing this onion. Hopefully I don't slice my finger with it.
It's a very sharp knife.
Yes,
I think I gave you the sharpest knife.
Yeah. So for those of you who don't know, the Ladle TV program is a cooking show program that the Ladle's been doing, where we give boxes, meal kits of ingredients to people ahead of time, and they sign up. And then we cook the food a couple of days later on our Instagram. And if you're just scrolling through Instagram and you see this and you're like, oh, I don't have time to watch it right now, that's okay, because we're going to save it to our Instagram live. And then we're also going to be putting video on YouTube as well.
Oh, really? And,
yeah. Yes, you're gonna be all over.
Oh my god, I'm getting famous.
Oh, someone says, I'm so excited to see Kelly cook.
Oh,
yay! So for those of you who are tuning in on Instagram, if you have any questions or comments for Kelly, you can just type them in the chat, and I will pass them on so that Kelly can answer your questions.
Okay, here I'm ready with the green onions and the onions. So I separately put the white part and then the green part.
Mm-hmm.
And then this is finely diced onion. Mm-hmm. I've only used half of it.
Okay.
Now I'm
getting
to the garlic.
And I think we should
do
2 foot
of
garlic.
I think 3 is 3 maybe.
Or
the more the better.
The more the better. I find I always double the amount of garlic.
Yes.
They never cost enough.
Gives a nice flavor.
Yeah.
So here's a little tip for dealing the garlic. So I usually mash it first so that you can peel it off easily. So if you have a garlic presser, you can use that as well.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we're gonna finally dice the garlic. Let's get rid of the end of it. Okay. See, when you mash it, it's just easier to slice it.
Mm. Yeah, you're getting it really nice and thin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, get to the topping.
So would you say this is like one of your go-to recipes that you
cook? Oh, definitely. It's my comfort food.
Yeah.
I would say the fried rice is my comfort food.
Mm-hmm.
But I rarely make the same fried rice twice.
Because
it's always, I'm using like whatever I have in my fridge.
Mm-hmm.
Except for this tofu fried rice, because I've been practicing with my recipe.
Yeah.
For this show. But honestly, you can use a lot of things. There's a lot of possibility in fried rice.
Mm-hmm.
Just whatever you have in your fridge. And the best part is you can wrap up all your leftovers.
Yeah. Yes, I know that you said that the best way to make the fried rice is to start with rice that is leftover, right?
Yes.
You get that nice texture.
Yes.
Yeah.
is this quite satisfying when you have a little bit of this and then a little bit of that, and then you just wrap them all up into a fried rice, and then they turn out amazing.
That's great, and I feel like the whole point of this series is about teaching students ways that they can stretch their food budget and eat healthy and make dishes that don't take a lot of time. So I think that that's great that with fried rice you can make it so versatile and just use your leftovers.
Okay, so now I'm gonna do the eggs.
Okay.
I'm gonna use 2 eggs. Usually, like, for 1 people, I use 1 egg. So today we're making 2 servings.
So if you just tuned in, we're making tofu fried rice right now.
Yep. Okay, so I'm going to use a fork to whisk it. If you have chopsticks, you can use chopsticks. If you have a whisker, you can also use a whisker. Do we have salt?
Yes. Let me just grab it. I'm going to do a slow backup.
The small one? I think so.
Yep, one. You're right.
Thank you.
You're
this
welcome.
It's a basket of
live. Now people will know that this is really live.
Wow, a whole basket of salt.
Somebody asks, is this your favorite dish, Kelly, and do you use any condiments?
Yes. I would say fried rice is my favorite comfort food. But the variety is a lot, so yeah, I try a lot of different combinations of it. So this one is on purposely designed for this cooking show because we want it to be vegetarian. And usually I will use some sort of protein, like chicken or pork. But in this dish, the protein will be tofu, the tofu here, and then the eggs. And the condiments will be soy sauce, and then the sesame oil, and then just the salt. This is like the basic condiments. And then on top of that, you can just adjust with your preference. But you can put chili oil if you prefer something spicy. And then just whisk it finely. And then a slice of tofu.
I'll zoom in on the onions again. So if you don't have the recipe in front of you, we've used 1 regular onion, 2 green onions that Kelly separated the green parts and the white parts. We've got 2 eggs that are beat up, and then we have maybe 4 or 5 garlic cloves.
6.
So we're starting with rice that it's pre-cooked because it's best to use the leftover rice for fried rice. I'm only going to use half of the tofu, and
I will line the plate with some kitchen towel.
Oh yes, with the water.
Yes, it's a great idea. So there's a lot of residual water from the tofu.
Somebody asked, but I think maybe you've already answered this question. Is this a dish that could be done with any leftovers?
Yes,
yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Yes, definitely any kind of leftover you have in your fridge.
Yeah. I'm curious if anybody watching wants to type in the chat if you've made fried rice before, what your favorite variety of fried rice is, what you like to put in your fried rice.
Me?
Or I'm just saying for anyone that's watching, but also for you too.
Yeah.
What would be your favorite?
I would like to hear from the audience.
From the audience, yes. Okay, audience, don't be shy. Let us know what you like to put in your fried rice. There's someone's putting this on the paper towel. Oh, here we have an answer. Eggs, carrots, cabbage, and bell peppers.
Oh yeah.
Yummy. That's a good combo.
Yeah. And I can imagine it would be a colorful form of rice.
I personally really like cabbage in my fried rice. I feel like it just like soaks up the oil and the salt and the soy sauce so well.
All the flavors.
Yeah. And some sriracha, I guess.
Oh, yes.
Definitely sriracha.
Cubes, just cutting everything into bite size,
and that's like half a container.
Yes. Yeah, half of a 400-gram. Okay, I think we are ready with the ingredients. Also, open this.
Oh, we have another response. It says, "I've only tried the Thai brand, Khao Phat Gai, which is with chicken and a lot of chili."
Yeah.
It's the other way.
Oh, sorry, I don't know how to use it.
Oh yeah, it's confusing. It kind of goes on the top.
Is it like this? It's
yeah, you got it. Do you want me to check?
Yes,
I heard
please.
It. Okay.
Did I get it?
I think
it
yeah.
Like a pop. Yeah, it's kind of hard to tell that it's opening when you're twirling it.
It didn't crack on the edge.
There's also another. Oh, yes, thank you. Thank you, Oscar. I like that. Alright. Okay, yeah. It's hard to tell that it's opening because it kind of comes on the outside.
Oh, is it already? Is it already open?
Yeah, is there more? I think there's a little bit. Right? Do you want to call me?
Yeah.
So Leo from the chat box says that he has tried the Thai version and with some chicken and a lot of chili.
Yes. Is this a dish you like to make too?
Yeah, love fried rice. Yeah. I feel like it's a favorite dish for every Asian.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the key of making like Thai fried rice.
Mm-hmm.
It's took the lime juice and the fish sauce. If you put these two condiments, instantly it'll become Thai flavor.
Okay, am I ready for everything?
I think so.
Yep. Do you need me to grab you anything?
I think I'm just gonna start with cooking rice from raw.
Okay.
So that
sure.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because it took some time.
So this is 1.5 cups dry vegetables.
Okay. Yeah. I don't know if this pot is too little for like a
maybe.
Hub and hub.
Let's see.
I think it's okay.
I can just go with 1 cup of rice.
Sure.
It's just for demonstration. Okay, I'll just use that.
Yeah.
So, you went for it.
Oh yeah, no. I like it prime the pump. Everyone's getting to see all the weird.
Okay,
there we go.
Magic.
Yeah.
Okay, first we'll start with washing the rice because the rice is with all the starch surrounds it. So
mm-hmm.
by washing it, we'll get rid of the starch. I wash it for about 3 to 4 times. Just wash it until the water looks clear. For fried rice, the ideal texture is The ideal texture for the rice is the rice should be very individually separated, and then it shouldn't be too wet. So the every single grain should be separate. You don't want it too sticky.
No.
Are they looking more clearer?
Oh yeah.
Yes. Better. Just gonna give it one glass. There you go. It's already like very clear.
Oh yeah, it's so clear.
Yep. So my trick of cooking rice from raw in this pot is you can put your finger to the top of the rice, and then when you see the, it's a little bit more. So you can measure the water to the first knuckle, to your first knuckle. That'll be how much water to go into the rice. Okay, now we can move to the stove. Okay.
We just
left
this.
Yeah, but sorry, yeah. Look at that.
Okay.
Okay.
There you go. You gotta use this.
Sure.
Okay. I'm just gonna bring the water to a hot boil. Okay. So after it's boiling, we'll see the water reduce. And then, so at the meantime, the rice is absorbing water, and then when the surface touches the rice, we know it's the time to turn down the heat and then put the lid on. Mm-hmm. So right now it's just letting it to boil, to a hot boil. So here we can prepare our water. Okay, just gonna leftover rice. Maybe I want to show everyone. It's like cold. It's just cool down, so it's easy to work with when frying it.
There is a small here.
Okay.
If you wanna.
You want it to feel like you're just at home looking for one of these or these.
It's like a chef.
Yeah, exactly.
I use this one. You know, it's okay. Now I wanted to show her a trick of how you know the oil is hot enough. So I like to just put my fork. Usually I'll work with chopsticks, that's easier to tell. But like when you drop some egg drops in, you see it start bubbling with all the egg drops in there. And now you know the heat is ready. Oil is ready. Okay. Did the fan just automatically?
Yeah, it just automatically does that.
Okay. Hello, I'm here.
So right now when it's heating up, you can see the edges of the eggs start to fluff up and it's getting airy, and now we can start moving it.
Now it's more hot.
Yeah, because the egg is not coming together.
Oh, now it's doing it.
Alright, for eggs in the fried rice, I prefer the eggs not to be fully cooked. I like it to come to like 80% cooked, so that later you can attach the rice. Just gonna move it out first. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
So once again, if anybody on Instagram has any questions about what Kelly's doing, you can just type them in the comments.
Okay. Turning the heat to medium. I'm gonna add some more oil. There we go. And right after the egg, we're gonna fry the tofu in the oil. Because the tofu are relatively fragile to work with, it breaks up pretty easily. And then if we fry them first in the oil, it kind of forms a layer on the outside, so it doesn't break easily when you fry them with the rice.
That's really smart.
Just be gentle with the tofu. I'm frying them over medium heat, I think.
It's okay.
Just toss them from time to time, and when you start to see it, the surface starts to browning. It looks golden brown. You know it's time to flip it. Give it some time to let the heat do the magic work. Okay, can you move here to see the rice?
Go ahead.
Now when the water comes to boil, you can see there are holes where the steam can come out. Also the water is like reducing to touch the surface of the rice. We'll give it like 2 minutes more before we turn down the heat.
So that's how you know it's ready.
Yes. That's why like in the beginning the volume of the water doesn't really matter that much. Because the water evaporates and it also absorbed by the rice.
Okay, I always wondered how that works because like every pot is a different
yes.
size.
Yes, also everyone's yeah. knuckle is different.
Yeah,
even
exactly.
though we use a trick.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a great trick.
Now you can almost see the surface of the rice is coming out. Remember before it was like not so far from the water. also the tofu starts to be golden brown on one side. Now we're just gonna flip it. Give it a toss. Gonna take a few. There you go. This is when, you know, it starts to be strong enough to be fried with the rice.
That's great. I love that you're giving us all these close ups.
Yep. By the way, we're doing it on in a wok, but you don't have to have a wok for fried rice. You can just use your nonstick pan. But the wok is authentic. Every Asian family probably have one. Alright, look at the rice. Now it's really the water is reduced and then touching the rice. Now we'll reduce the heat.
Now it's 86. Yeah, he just put it there.
Oh, yeah, great. Let's go much easier. I thought I could do the timer without turning on the loud one, but I can't.
Okay, so right now the most part of the tofu already golden brown, so all the surface. So we'll just stick it in the wok and try with everything else. We'll push it to the side of the wok. And I'm gonna add a little bit more oil. In the oil so they get a time to infuse their flavor into the oil. So their flavor is going to distribute into the oil and later on the oil will carry the flavor into the rice. When you fry the onions and the garlic, keep the heat at about medium or medium low.
Someone in the comment section said there's no sound. Can someone, if anyone hear any sound, can someone put in the comments and let us know?
Oh, is it a sound at all?
Don't know.
Maybe it's because the way that we are hanging the cell phone.
Just frying the aromatics in the pot, in the oil, so that the flavor can be distributed into the oil, and then later on the flavor will be carried to the rice. We keep the heat on low or like medium low is because the garlic is easily burnt, and we don't want to burn the garlic because burnt garlic is bitter.